Hey YouTube, this is Farmall 51 here. Come to you today, let you know, if you hadn't already heard, I guess you will now, a good friend of ours, well, in our international collectors group here, and the large community of antique, you know, tractor collectors, Caterpillar people, and stuff like that, last Saturday, good friend of ours, Mr. Ken Eder, had passed away. He was killed in a work-related accident on the railroad. As many of you know, he cleaned up train wrecks. That was his business, Mideast Railroad. I can't think of the whole name of the company now, but Mideast Railroad is who he owned and worked for, and they cleaned up train wrecks. Anything the railroad needed, you know, clean up, heavy, you know, lifting, you know, like I say, he did it all. Was killed. I'm not going to go into details, but but yeah, he was killed Saturday, sometime I think Saturday morning. So, but it's kind of a big shock to a lot of us because he puts on the 100 Years of Progress show in Carthage, North Carolina, about every November. He opens up his doors there, and if you've ever been there, he's got a almost fully stocked International Harvester dealership built, and Caterpillar, sort of a Caterpillar dealership built, a building built, numerous buildings, and just the more tractors and stuff than you could even imagine. Probably one of the largest steam engine collections known around, probably in the U.S., if not the world. Like I say, if you've ever, I know you've seen in some of my past videos, when we've been at 100 Years of Progress, I've took some drone video and things like that, but yes, it's real sad. It's going to be a big loss. As far as I know, of course, they're just rumors, but they're possibly going to do one more show next year. It's supposed to be a big Caterpillar show, which everything's, you know, welcome there. But they're going to have the national, I think, the Caterpillar Collectors, Antique Caterpillar Collectors Club or something like that there. And they're planning a pretty big event, but unfortunately, Ken won't be with us there. So hopefully they'll follow through and go with it. But if you want more details on what's happening right now, go to the Ederville Carthage Facebook page. I'm not sure if they have a website or not, but I know they have a Facebook page. But go there and they'll keep you updated on details and stuff like that. But this Wednesday, and I can't think of the date right now, top of my head, this Wednesday here, coming Wednesday, they'll be doing the wake there in Carthage, and I'm sure on the Facebook page you'll have the details of where that's at. And Thursday they will have the funeral there on site at the international, or not the funeral, but the viewing, I guess. He will be cremated, I believe, and he will be there at the international dealership. So, but like I say, comes as a big shock to us. I learned Saturday afternoon after it had happened last Saturday. And like I say, it's going to be a big loss because he was a huge, huge collector. Like I say, the largest, probably one of the largest steam engine collections in the world, if not the U.S. there, but in quite a few other. He collected everything. I mean, everything, foreign stuff, you know. But I think his passion was Caterpillar steam engines and international equipment. But like I say, be a big loss, and hate that happened. I mean, you know, but as we, you know, the Bible teaches us, you know, we're not promised tomorrow, and you know, take each day as it comes there, and live that day, you know, to the fullest, and because you're not promised tomorrow, anything can happen. So, but anyway, like I say, hope that explains a lot there. Like I say, if you need any more details, go on the Ederville Carthage Facebook page, and they'll be glad to point you in the give you some more information. So, All right. Thanks for watching.